Hello students, welcome to the class on meeting. The objective of this session is to orient you towards the concept and types of meeting. So let's begin with introduction. Meetings are part of our day-to-day life. We all attend meeting for wide variety of reasons and interests. It could be work, personal interest or any other allied activities. Most of us take part in meeting during some point in our lives, while some of them do it on a regular basis. Before we go ahead and further explore the concept of meeting, let us first understand what meetings are. Meetings. A meeting is a gathering of people to present or exchange information, plan joint activities, make decisions, or carry out any actions which are already agreed upon. Meeting may be defined as gathering or assembling or getting together of a number of persons for transacting any lawful business. In a meeting, two or more people formally come together to discuss one or more topics, often in a formal settings. Meetings may occur face to face or virtually, as mediated by communications technology such as a telephone conference call or a video conference. Students, one can distinguish a meeting from other gatherings, such as a chance encounter, which is not conveyed. A sports game or a concert, which is a verbal interaction, is just incidental. A party or the company of friends, where there is no common goal which is to be achieved, and a demonstration, whose common goal is achieved mainly through the number of demonstrators present, not through any verbal interaction. Let us now focus on the purpose and objectives of the meeting. Students, meetings are called for several objectives. Some of them are listed herewith. To give common instructions to a group. To save time on communication. To solve a problem or problems. To recognize the efforts of the group members. To appraise the situation. To get new ideas from the group, to seek any clarifications, to discuss the proposals or the ways of working, to motivate the team, to resolve any conflicts. Although meetings have so many positives, but if not conducted effectively, it can lead to confusion, conflicts, wastage of time and resources. Students, a poorly conducted meeting can also result in low morale of the members and putting a negative impact on further meetings of the organization. While meetings may differ in size, content and approach, effective meetings all have the listed three elements in common. They are a distinctive purpose or an aim, use of effective communication and a controlled situation. In general, meetings are seen as effectively if they have a purpose, have a specific agenda, have a proper quorum, have a chair who controls the proceedings, have a structure and keep to the point, have someone who records the proceed and someone who keeps to the time, and make decisions if required. Students, let us now focus our discussion towards the components of meetings that are very essential. A meeting can be divided into listed three main components. They are content, interaction, and structure. Let us learn more about them. Content is the knowledge, information, experience, expertise, opinions, ideas, attitudes, and expectations that each individual brings to a meeting. While interaction is the way in which the participants work together to deal with the content of a meeting. This includes the feelings, attitudes, and the expectations of the participants, which have a direct bearing on cooperation, listening, participation, and trust. While structure is the way in which both the information and the participants are organized to achieve the purpose or the objectives of the meeting. Students, let us now discuss the types of meeting. To be very precise, meetings are generally only of two types, that is, formal meetings and informal meetings. Formal meetings are held at a definite time, at definite place, and usually for a definite duration to follow an agreed agenda. However, informal meetings don't meet any or all of the criteria which are listed herewith. However, in both the types of meetings, it is very important to understand the exact nature of meeting. It helps in deciding goals, structure, and activities which are best suited for the concerned meetings. Students, let us now discuss the most popular six types of meetings, which are status update meetings, information sharing meetings, decision making meetings, problem solving meetings, innovation meetings, and team building meetings. Let us further explore these types of meeting in further detail. Number 1. Status update meetings. Students, status update meetings are one of the most common meeting types. This category includes regular team and project meetings, where the primary goal is to align the team via the updates on the progress, challenges, and the next steps to be taken. Status update meetings can be an efficient and concise way of communicating current updates and tasks among the various team members and unite the team around its shared goals. The primary purpose of status update meeting is to update and align a team or a department on the current state of the project or overall direction to the entire group. Students, often this involves contributions from each participant, which then leads to a group discussion involving any problem solving, decision making, prioritization, or task assignment which is necessary to move forward. It is important that meeting members make contributions not only when sharing their own information, but also while listening to the updates. Status update meetings are the most effective when participants take an active role in aligning their individual goals as well as the team goals with the goals of the organization or the company. To do this, participants should listen closely to all other participants and ask questions or raise concerns when they arise. This increases mutual understanding and support throughout the group. Students, status update meetings across multiple groups involves team leaders representing and reporting similar things on behalf of their team to other representatives. Number 2. Information sharing meetings. Presentations, panel debates, keynotes, workshops, and lectures are all the examples of information sharing meetings. The primary goal of this type of meeting is for the speaker to share the information with the attendees. This takes attendees from passive spectators to active participants, making the meeting more engaging, enjoyable, and effective for all. Depending on the setting, there are several goals that would lead you to choose an information sharing meeting formats. Sometimes the presenter is presenting information in order to persuade the group, while the other times the intention might be more educational purpose. Meeting goals may also differ based on the content and the provider of the information. Often, the setting is a larger group, like a conference or a panel discussion audience, where the primary goal is to educate the audience on a topic relevant to them, while other times the setting is smaller groups like workshops and training sessions. Students, the biggest challenge in information sharing meetings is to keep audience members engaged and involved throughout the presentation, so that they take in the information which is being shared and learn from it. Various techniques and technologies can be used to engage them and involve audience members in the presentation. Here, another key challenge is finding the proper vibrant between the presenter and the audience. Often, there can be a disconnect between the two. These can be caused by the presenter not knowing enough about his or her audience, causing issues like presenting content that is either too complex or too basic, or focusing on issues that are less interesting to the audience, while not going in depth on the issues that are truly interested to them, that is the audience. Students, this disconnect can cause the audience to become disengaged and bored, which in turn frustrates the presenter. Without audience engagement, information sharing meetings can easily become boring and tedious. Involving the audience as active listeners by providing channels for them to ask questions and give feedback is an excellent way to make sure the group is engaged and is paying attention. Audience members are often quite knowledgeable or at a minimally very interested in the subject which is being presented. Taking advantage of the knowledge in the room by collecting input and the feedback both engages the audience members and helps the presenter gain important information about the audience's background and their interests. This collected feedback also helps the presenter evaluate the effect of the meeting and identify improvements for future meetings. Number 3, decision-making meetings. The vast majority of business decisions are made in meetings. While small decisions are made in all kinds of meetings, the more important decisions often get their own dedicated meetings. Students, there are different types of group decision-making processes, and care should be taken to choose a process that best matches the situation. A decision-making process can include group activities like information gathering and sharing, brainstorming solutions, evaluating options, ranking various preferences, and voting on the final options which are provided. Goals for the decision-oriented meeting can vary a little based on the type of decision which is being made, but they are always centered on coming to a consensus about a future plan. It is important to remember that the goal of these meetings also includes planning how to best execute the decisions that has been made. Students, by involving a group in making a decision, you can rely on collective intelligence, knowledge beyond what is possible with individual decision makers. Because each participant has unique information and perspectives, combining group information leads to a more informed decision making. However, it is important to use meetings which are designed specifically for group decisions efficiently to not waste the group members' time. If all the planning decisions were made by one person, not only would the choices be uninformed, there would also be little unity around the team goals and the directions. Participatory decision making leads to the increased team productivity and likelihood of goal executions, because team member feels ownership and responsibility for the decisions which are being made. Students, for decision making meetings, it is particularly important to include all relevant persons with authority to carry out the decisions. If decisions are made without including the relevant people, it could often be very challenging to implement the resulting decisions. Students, further, making group decisions can be hard. Making group decisions is even more challenging. However, good decisions are what can make or break your project or even your company or a career. Being aware of the most common challenges in decision-making meetings will move you closer to the facilitating successful group decision-making decisions. The challenges in successful decision-making meetings are incomplete information, narrow perspectives, identification of workable solution with due respect. Number 4, problem-solving meetings. Problem-solving meetings are oriented around solving either a specific or a general problem and are perhaps the most complex and varied type of meetings. Students, at problem-solving meetings, the outcome is often an important decision, and thus meetings can be crucial to the development of a team or product. If wrong action is chosen, it could be hugely damaging. The key objective for problem-solving meetings is to find the most optimal solution that can resolve an issue facing the group or the organization. Students, in order to do this, the group first has to identify possible solutions and then evaluate this on the basis of relevant requirements and the criteria. Further, problem-solving meetings should be oriented around issues that affect and are only resolvable by the team. If the problem is the responsibility of or can be fixed by one person, a group meeting is likely a waste of time. Often, the most successful problem-solving meetings are ones that happen before a major issue arises. Taking time to identify potential future problems allows a team to have solutions immediately ready. Unfortunately, problem-solving meetings are all too often done only after a problem occurs, adding a variety of challenges that would not exist in other meeting types. Students, the best way to approach a problem-solving meeting is to first properly define the problem and the restrictions of potential solutions. Before brainstorming solutions, evaluate them and decide on the best one. Innovation meetings. The idea behind innovation meetings is that participants will build off of one another ideas, creating a product of their collective intelligence that is better than what each of them could have come up with their own. Even if no one member of the team has a brilliant idea, much better ones can result from sharing and combining insights from people with complementary insights and due experiences. Students, innovation meetings and creative meetings often start with thinking outside the box, brainstorming, associating and sharing ideas in a broader scope. Meeting participants can then use various techniques and processes to reduce the diverse pool of ideas to a more focused, shorter list. Through ranking, evaluations and decision making, the most suitable idea or ideas is identified and recommendation and task can be assigned to them. Students, the primary goal of an innovation meeting is to leave with either a new or a redesigned approach to a current project or a problem. The process of reaching this desired outcome is generally straightforward. Innovation usually starts with broad, creative thinking, often in the form of a brainstorm in which many ideas are generated and shared. These suggestions are then narrowed down into a more concise list, which can be refined, evaluated, and discussed in order to highlight the drawbacks and benefits of each idea. Through group assessment, evaluations, and various voting methods, a final choice is made and a best path is determined. Once this has been done, steps for bringing this idea to life can be discussed and tasks can be assigned to the members of the team. Number 6. Team building meetings. One of the best ways to get everyone on your team working well together and moving towards the same goals is to conduct regularly scheduled team building meetings. These meetings can be critical components in establishing your team culture, which is a key element to productivity and success. Students, the primary goal for team building meetings are to improve the way the team members work together. This can be done by fostering a collaborative environment, connecting team members who may not see each other than often, and aligning everyone's efforts towards the same goals. Team building meetings are great channels for communicating your overall team goals and strategies. They also give team members an opportunity to present how they will contribute to reaching these goals. Students, this is an invaluable because it gives team members an opportunity to gain a deeper understanding of where they fit and how they depend on each other to achieve the overall goals of the organizations. Team building meetings are all about the team. They need to be inclusive, and team authorities should participate alongside with the rest of the team members. Students, the book Running Meetings have prescribed basics of making your meetings more effective. It prescribes some guidelines for the same, which are: understand why are you meeting, setting an agenda, proper sequencing of agenda items, assignment of agenda items to the particular participants, identifying the participants and inviting them to the meetings, assignment of various roles to the participants, which includes facilitator, note keeper, timekeeper, experts, etc. Coming to the conclusion part. Students, with this I would like to conclude by mentioning that we have finished discussing about the concept of meetings. We also briefly discussed about the various types of meetings. With this, I would like to conclude this session. Thank you.